God is going to do something miracle in your life. Type amen if you believe on that. From Melbourne. Welcome, church, to 6:30 service. Hello, everyone. Thank you for giving me this opportunity in behalf of my pastor, Pastor Lotte Giao and Pastor Jeanette. Thank you so much for tuning in, guys. Thank you. Hello sa inyong lahat. Hello, mga kababayan there in the Philippines. There in Macau, who's watching right now in Hong Kong. From across the globe, in UK, in USA, in Europe. Thank you so much for tuning in, guys. If you haven't watched yet this live stream, please subscribe and share this live stream with your family. Mention their names, share it to their groups, and come and join us, guys. Maraming salamat po. Hello, Kuya Seren, Justin, thank you so much. I know you're just watching there at home. You must be watching in your car, in your lounge, in your sa sala ninyo, sa kwarto mo. I know it is a tough situation happening right now in this pandemic crisis. Everyone is being affected in this crisis, especially there in the Philippines. Nagkaroon ng extension din sa quarantine, and it's very sad and depressing. But I know, hopefully this live stream right now, in this online service right now, I'm going to share a very important message to every one of you. If you're watching, please do so. Share this video. Continue in sharing it. Continue to mention their names. If you haven't clicked this, the like button, please do so. And click the thumbs up. And also yung heart. I will speaking in English and in Tagalog at the same time as well to reach out. I will speak in English to reach out some of the other nationalities so they can understand as well. So in general, I will just mix up yung second language ko as Tagalog. So maraming salamat po. Ayan kay Celine, kay Kuya Mark, kay Kaiser, my disciple. Hello, and Pastor Jeanette, thank you so much po for watching. We're just starting. I know madami pa tayong mga viewers, so we'll just encourage one another to share this to our family, into different groups, and also to your friends. Ayan, maraming salamat po. Hi, padamihin pa natin yung mga watcher, mga viewers ng ating live stream. Ayan, before we going to start, maraming salamat. Hello po, Dad, Pastor Lotte Giao. Thank you so much for letting me to preach tonight. Yan, maraming salamat po. So I'm just here right now in my room, and tonight, etong time dito sa Melbourne po. So I'm from Melbourne, Australia po. So I'm currently studying here right now, and I've been assigned today to do the live stream. I'm one of the primary 12 po ni Pastor Jeanette Giao and Pastor Lotte Giao. Hello po, Kuya Seren. Ayan, wave po tayong lahat. Let us wave. Ayan, maraming salamat. Hi, Leslie in Canada. Please, kung nanonood kayo, if you're watching right now, please type where are you watching. If you're watching from home, in Canada, in Philippines, in Macau, in Hong Kong, please do so. Type natin para mas madami pang maka-attract ng mga viewers natin. Ayan, hello, Tita Mona. Hello po sa inyong lahat. I hope all you're watching with your family. Please bring your notes so we can start starting this live stream as well. So stay tuned and keep watching. And so we're already having 25 viewers. Praise God! Yay! All right, keep boosting. Let's boost out this live stream right now. And so, all right, so before we start, let us pray po muna. Mag-pray po muna tayong lahat. And ayan, hello po Kuya Arma from Baguio City. Hello pa sa inyong lahat dyan sa Baguio City. I just acknowledge all the people there in Baguio, which is my hometown. Hello Yvonne, Andrew. Hello po sa inyong lahat. I miss you all po. Ayan, thank you so much for watching and tuning in this live stream. Ayan, let us start. Let us pray all of everyone. Lord, maraming salamat for this evening that you have gathered us in this virtual online live stream. Thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity. Lord God, you're going to break out all the barriers, all the walls, Lord God, in this pandemic crisis right now. I pray, Lord God, the word tonight will going to make an impact, will make a big revelations in every one of us, Lord God, that will make a twist, Lord God, and make a breakthrough in every one of us, even to our families, to our friends, to our relatives all over the world, Lord God. Thank you so much. May your mighty hand be with us. May your presence will saturate us, will engulf us with your blood. Protect us, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hello po, Tita Margaret in Hong Kong. Hello po sa inyong lahat. Ayan, wave from Australia. Ayan, so I know sa ating pong lahat, we're struggling. Some of them are struggling right now. Madaming mga hindi na reach out ang mga bahay because of the poor cooperation. Ayan, so I hope lahat ng mga who don't have the internet connection right now, ayan, I pray that God will provide the internet connection para sa inyong lahat para makanood kayo. Hello po kay Ate Limay in Saudi, in Middle East. Hello. Welcome. Thank you for tuning in kay Kay Zelda. Ayan, thank you. Please continue to mention all your families, your disciples to watch this live stream. Ayan, so I'm going to share to you right now the 5 R's in this COVID-19 pandemic crisis. Ayan, hello po, Kuya Mark, watching from the Pearl of the Orient, Philippines. Woo! Hello mga kababayan. Hi Trixie, welcome. Hello, I miss you all. Ayan ka AJ, hello, I miss you. Ayan, so I'm just repeating this. I'm going to share to you the 5 R's in this COVID-19 pandemic crisis. And number one, just an introduction in here. So number one R is restoring. So in this pandemic crisis, I'm going to share this 5 R's COVID-19 pandemic crisis. Ayan, so number one is restoring. So God is restoring every homes, every families, every businesses in all over the world. And also God is decreasing the harmful effects of the global warming right now because of this pandemic crisis. So basically, these are the positive things that God is doing right now during this unprecedented time. So yun, number two, God is refining us. So since we are being isolated, being having the quarantine at home, and we're just not allowed to go out here in Melbourne, so we're not locked down apparently, but still we have the stage jurisdiction, so there are only 4 reasons that we need to go out. So basically we need to go out just because of shopping, just because of exercise, going for work, and going for study. So those are the 4 reasons. But then and we're so blessed that despite of this happening of all the cases, na not too much, hindi madaming mga cases, mga death cases dito. So unlike in other countries, in USA, in the Philippines, even and in China, so we're so safe here and protected. So we are so blessed that we are being disciplined here right now. But despite others are like breaching the restrictions right now, but I hope sa inyong lahat there in the Philippines also, please do so to cooperate with the discipline that is God is doing right now. Kung sinabi ni Lord, sinabi ng ating president to stay home, please do so. So yeah, number three, God is reuniting every families, every communities, and government officials and even other countries, they're being united already, being collided. Ayan, even different organizations from different institutions as well, yeah, nag-unite na sila to give relief goods, to provide PPEs. And so those are the positive things. And number four, God is rebuilding and replenishing us. And God is replenishing us. So God is filling us in full right now. Kung dati, di ba, lagi kang busy sa work. Lagi kang busy sa work. Ayan, hello kay Erica from Toronto, Canada. Hello. Thank you for watching. Ayan, so yan, God is like rebuilding and replenishing us. As like I've said a while ago. Kung dati, you are just being so empty. You don't have time to go to church. You don't have to time to watch the live stream. You don't have to time to pray and to read the Bible. God right now is isolating us for us to be focused and meditate and be filled with the fruits of the Holy Spirit, with the presence of God. And also, God is rebuilding and replenishing our relationship to Him as well. Dati, from no faith, yan, from a low faith, and now God is building an extraordinary faith from us. Say amen. Tama po ba? Right? Come on. Please, mag-thumbs up po kayo if you're agreeing with that. So God is accelerating our faith from the lowest level to highest level. Amen po ba? Ayan, amen. Praise God. Thank you. Please keep on engaging in this live stream para maramdaman ko naman na kayo are agreeing in the word of the Lord. Ayan, amen. Hello kay Joy, kay Kuya Jason, and thank you for watching. Stay tuned, guys, and finish this live stream. And then number five, God is reviving us. Ayan, revival. Ayan, so God is reviving us from sorrow to joy. Lahat ngayon, madaming mga full of heavy burden. Madami ngayon, full of worries, full of doubt. Pero ngayon, God is turning our sorrow to joy. Instead of depending on our fear, ngayon right now, God is changing and shifting us from sorrow to joy, from pain to relief. Ayan, di ba? Madami ng mga nakaka-recover. Lahat ng mga infected by the COVID-19. They are being recovered already. Ayan. So God is shifting us from sorrow to joy, from pain to relief, from sickness to healing. Ayan. God is healing right now every one of us, spiritually, emotionally, mentally, physically as well. Ayan. And from religion to relationship with God. Amen po ba? Right? God is reviving us right now. Lahat ng mga backsliders, lahat ng mga nawala sa presensya ng Panginoon, God is rejuvenating our hearts. God is knocking on our doors na nagsasabi, oh, kapatid, ito na yung pandemic crisis. Minsan, di ba ngayon, dati ngayon, nireneglect lang natin si Lord. Ini-ignore lang natin siya, ini-ignore lang natin yung disciple natin. Natin, yung pastor natin na sinasabi, oh, go back to church already, but then, right now, we are shutting our doors. Pero ngayon, ito, ginagamit ni Lord yung COVID-19 na ito, yung mga dating hindi nananalangin. Magugulat ka na lang, Lord, thank you, Lord. Tingnan mo yung mga post nila. Lord, heal our land. Yan, di ba, nagkakandara pa yung mga, ano, yung mga post na mga ganyan. Kasi bakit? Takot na sila. Gusto na lang ma-save. Kaya ngayon, God is doing a revival in this generation right now. In this millennial generation. But then, anong kailangan natin gawin? In these 5 R's na sinabi ko, na-mention ko kanina, I'll just repeat it. Ayan, yung topic po natin today is the 5 R's in this COVID-19 pandemic crisis. Ulitin ko lang po, number one, God is restoring. Yan, restoring every home, every families, every businesses. Number two, God is refining us. Yan, dinidisiplina tayo ng Panginoon. Kinokorek niya tayo, nire-rebuke niya tayo. Yung mga stubborn, yung mga hindi humble, ay nina-humble down ni Lord. Number three, God is reuniting every families. Yung mga dati lagi na lang busy. Lagi busy sa work, busy sa mga kaibigan, barkada. Pero ngayon, pinagsasama-sama na ni Lord lahat ng mga buong pamilya para mag-unite, to pray, to worship the Lord. Tama po ba? Amen? Alright, and number four, God is rebuilding and replenishing our relationship to Him. Yan, from no faith to extraordinary faith. And number five, God is doing revival right now. Yan, from sorrow to joy, from pain to relief, and from sickness to healing. And yung mga dati, intact lang from religion to relationship with Jesus. Yan, God is shifting us. Dati, they're just being atheists. A lot of people watching right now, if you're watching right now, if you're, you just like, randomly watch this live stream, I do encourage you to watch this till the end. Kasi bakit? God is going to do something miracle in your life. Type amen if you believe on that. So God is building an instant intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. Amen po ba? Right. And so, but then, we now know all these positive things that God is doing in our lives during this pandemic crisis. But then, this is the thing that we need to do. I'm going to share to you the memorandum during crisis. Ayan. Alam na natin, oh, God is doing revival. God is doing replenishing. God is rebuilding us. But then, anong kailangan natin gawin? This is the memorandum. I'll just explain to you and refer to you what is memorandum. Memorandum is a note recording something for future use. Ayan. Ito, lagi nating naririnig ito sa schools. Ito, memorandum na pinapalagan ng mga teachers natin. Ayan. So, God is doing this. Ito, binibigyan tayo ng Panginoon ng memorandum during crisis. Ito, number one, memorandum. 101 memorandum. Type amen po. Ayan. If you are just watching continuously to put down kung saan ka pa nanonood, and if you're watching from different continent of the world, ayan, please type where you're watching right now. And if you're watching with your family, please click and subscribe. Click and share this. Sorry, guys. Click and share this live stream. Ayan. So, ayan, number one memorandum that we need to do during crisis. And number one, fix your thoughts. Ayan. Fix your thoughts. It says here in Philippians 4:8. Now, dear brothers and sisters, one final thing. Fix your thoughts on what is true and honorable, and right and pure and lovely and admirable. It says there. Think about the things that are excellent and worthy of praise. Amen? All right, keep on watching, guys. So we have already 34 viewers right now currently. So keep on boosting and sharing this live stream. Ayan, it says there, fix your thoughts. Ayan, number one that we need to do is fix your thoughts. Now that you've already, God says here, ayan, sabi ng Panginoon, fix your thoughts on what is true. Ayan, mag-focus tayo. Ayan, hello po kay Pastora Emmy watching from Hong Kong. Hello, how are you po? May God bless you there in Hong Kong. And yeah, it says here, fix your thoughts on what is true and honorable. Guys, we need to fix our thoughts, fix on the facts right now. Ayan, maniwala tayo. Hello po, watching from Macau. Hello po sa inyong lahat. Ni hao ma. Ni hao ma. Ayan, it says there, ayan. How are you? Hello po. Ayan, it says there, going back now, yan, sabi in, number one memorandum during crisis, we need to fix our thoughts from what is true, honorable, and right, and pure, lovely, and admirable. It says there, madami ngayon naniniwala, di ba, puro balita, ang lagi na lang mga laman ng balita, puro mga about COVID-19, madami ng lumalaganap na mga myths na hindi na totoo, na madami ng mga kwento. Yung iba yan, sinisiraan nila yung presidente nila. Yung iba yan, sinisiraan nila yung mga employers nila kasi hindi na sila binabayaran. Yung iba, nawawala na ng trabaho. And hello po, watching from Brunei. Thank you so much for tuning in sa inyong lahat. Please keep on watching, share this to your friends. Ayan. So, ayan, number one, fix your thoughts. But now that you know that you need to fix your thoughts, sabi pa ni dito, think about the things that are excellent and worthy of praise. Ayan, madami sa atin, bukang bibig na lang, COVID-19, madami, ang ginagawa na lang natin, nanonood na lang tayo na everyday. O ilan ba, tumataas pa ba? O nagre-recover ba yung mga tao? Ilan na yung mga deaths? So, kumbaga parang yun na lang, bukang bibid, yun na lang laman ng mga news, tama? Dun sa mga phones natin. Yes, lahat ng mga news. Pero ngayon, dapat ang kailangan natin pagtuonan ng pansin, right, is think about the things that are excellent and worthy of praise. Instead, magpuri ka kung ano yung mga, ayun, mag, mag, focus tayo more on dun sa mga magandang ginagawa ni Lord dito instead, the positive things. Yan, instead of the negative things na nangyayari sa buhay natin, sa pili na, sa pamilya natin. So instead of focusing on your worries, on your doubt, on your fear, on your hopelessness, oh, wala na akong pera, wala na akong pagkukuhanan ng relief goods, hindi na ako nabibigyan ng relief goods, wala na akong pagkain, I'm on the scarcity right now. Huwag tayong mag-focus dun. Huwag tayong mag-focus dun sa kung anong problema natin. Amen? Right now, ngayon, I need assess your needs. Now, sabi ng Panginoon, fix your thoughts. Pero kailangan nating assess one by one. Ano ba yung kailangan nating gawin? Assess your needs. Ayan, determine and classify your goals. Instead of focusing on to your fear right now, magkakaroon pa ba kaya ako ng trabaho pag natapos na itong COVID-19 nito? Or di kaya makaka-recover pa kaya yung business ko? Ayan, diba? We have our goals. Instead, focus on our goals right now. Ito, example natin. Diba? Lahat tayo may mga common goals. Meron tayong mga common dreams. Meron tayo gusto natin. I want to complete my strong 12. Multiply my strong leaders. My 12 disciples. Ayan, I want to train up my 12. My 144. 1728. I want to practice how to do 4Ps. Ayan, I want to shift my church. Expanding it, multiplying it from hundreds to thousands. Amen po ba? May mga pastor tayong mga gano'n na naniniwala na gusto nila yung from hundreds, talagang thousands, talagang big increased amount of ng mga cell members natin. Amen po ba? Right? At naniniwala na mga gano'n na mangyayari sa kanila. Ayan, gusto natin magkaroon tayo ng cell group. Gusto natin, Lord, I want, teach me how to preach. Ayan, yung mga dati, naniniwala sila na from being a novice to become an expert in forming up a successful business. Right? Tama, yung mga ganyan, yung mga goals natin, yung mga dreams natin. Aside from that, di ba gusto natin, Lord, paano kaya mag-earn? Gusto kong mag-earn ng 5,000 or million profit a month. Paano kaya mangyayari yun? Or gusto natin yung dreams natin, Lord, gusto ko ng house, ng church lot, ng building. Gusto ko ng business, mag-expand yung business ko. Ayan, gusto natin to prepare for marriage. Ayan, to engage in pre-marriage or counseling. Ayan. Gusto natin, di ba? Gusto kong maging successful to become successful in raising up a child or in the parenthood. Amen po ba? Gusto natin, ito yung madami tayong mga aspirations, madami tayong mga gustong mangyari sa buhay natin. Gusto natin maging successful. Tama po ba? Diba? Lahat tayo gusto namang maging successful. Sino bang hindi ayaw maging successful? Ayan. So, ngayon, ask yourself. Dito, instead of focusing dun sa problema nangyayari din sa global crisis, focus ngayon. Mag-focus ka dun sa goal mo. Focus ka dun sa dream, no? Dun sa prayer mo that you've been praying for the whole entire life mo. Ayan. Ask yourself. Tanongin mo yung sarili mo ngayon. Ayan. What's your goal? Ato, Ivy, ano nga bang goal ko? Ang goal ko is to become successful, to build up my business, and to raise up a nursing home, and to raise up my rental properties dyan sa Philippines and here in Australia as well, and to build up my 12 and my 144, ayan. So, yun, right? So, eto, kailangan natin gawin is mag-focus tayo, write down your what you want to do, what you want to achieve. Ayan, what you are dreaming for. Ito lagi kong nagiging routine na when I'm praying for something, sinusulat ko siya sa papel. Ayan, tapos pinapaskil ko dun sa, ito sa mga, dun sa pader ng kwarto ko. Ayan, ito punong-puno ng mga, kilala yan ng mga disciples ko, si Mami Jeanette. Ayan, they know me well na pinupost ko lahat ng mga prayers ko, ng mga goals ko. Kasi this keeps me being reminded daily that I need to focus on my goals instead of the negative realm that is happening in the world right now. So, you know, honestly, I'm not watching TV. I'm not watching, I'm not listening into the radio. And kasi bakit? Ito yung nagiging negative vibes lang yun. Eh. Yun ang nagsashutdown ng aking, ng faith, kumbaga, or ng aking strong ability or na agility, kumbaga ganun. Ayan, examine or diagnose any problems and issues right now. Ayan, it's happening right now. This, aside from dun sa COVID-19 ngayon, syempre madami sa atin ngayon na walan ng trabaho. Ayan, hindi na nag-ooperate yung business. Madami ngayon, wala nang pera, source of income, wala nang allowance kasi nasa bahay na lang. Ayan, kasi wala nang pasok. Ayan, wala na silang pagkukuhanan ng pangload nila or ng pangkain nila. So, a lot of people right now is experiencing scarcity and poverty. Pero now, we need to change our mindset, right? We need to change our mindset. Let us be positive. Let us be optimistic right now. Ayan, remove all your worries. Ayan, dapat kailangan takpan natin yung mata natin ng faith natin. Kumbaga, mas mananaig dapat yung faith natin instead of our worries and our doubts. Amen po ba? Madami ngayon, being stubborn, mas nananaig yung fear nila. Gusto nila ipaglaban instead yung ipaglaban nila yung pananampalataya nila kay Lord. Hindi, mas nananaig yung fear nila. Takot silang mamatay kasi hindi pa nila tinanggap si Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. Ayan. Madaming mga instances na nangyayari ngayon, lalo na po dito, right now in Australia. A lot of people right now here, they are Buddhist, they're atheist right now. A lot of people, unfortunately, doesn't accept Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. They're just depending on the government, on the system right now. But then, I'm praying and I'm desperately craving that everyone right now, pati mga friends ko, I'm sharing to them the gospel. Kasi, and a lot of people as well never heard about Jesus Christ. Because here in Australia, it's very strict that if you're preaching the gospel, even to the public, they will sue you. They will put you into jail. That's how strict they are here in Australia. But I know, I was so blessed when I heard, you know, the past 3 weeks I've heard, and when I watched the TV, that the Congress, the Prime Minister, they prayed, they started praying for Australia that everyone will recover, and I said, Lord, you are already doing revival in our country, in the whole world right now. Yung mga hindi mo inaasahan. Yan, mga Prime Minister pa yun, yung mga government officials here in Australia, they've been already connecting to Jesus Christ, and they're believing that God is saving in our all the population here in Australia, because a lot of people here, most of the population, they are aged. A lot of them, they are already in their 90s, 80s, which is very vulnerable right now. But then, you know, wala talaga imposible kay Lord. Amen po ba? Right? Ayan, instead of yan, we need to have a positive and godly perspective to achieve the desired outcome of our prayer. Ayan, sabi ito, speak positives. Speak and claim your victory in prayer. Ayan, declare your prayers has been answered. Lagi kong nagiging routine ito na sabi ko, Lord, I declare this week answered prayer na ako. Lord, this week, my prayer has been answered. Lord, this and that, I have it already. Dapat maging ganun tayo, maging routine natin yun, that they will thank the Lord, we'll have the spirit of gratitude na we thank the Lord that our prayers has been answered already. So yun, dapat, Lord, thank you, Lord, yung butas na bulsa ko, makaka-recover na. Ayan. Yung business ko, even despite of this COVID-19, pag natapos na ito, Lord, madaming mga clients na talagang bunch of clients that will going avail my services right now. Thank you, Lord. Dapat yung maging positive na ano natin, na declarations natin. Or pagbalik ko ng school, Lord, maraming salamat. Gagraduate na ako. Woo, magiging college na ako. Yeah, dapat din doon tayo i-shift natin yung mata natin, yung mga isipan natin doon sa mga bagay na gusto nating mangyari sa buhay natin, sa mga goals and aspirations natin. Ayan, doon tayo mag-focus. Yung tipong hindi pa nangyayari na, kasi bakit yun na yung focus ng mind mo? Amen po ba? Right? Ayan, sabi pa niya dito, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by renewing of your mind. Sabi niya, then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, and His good and pleasing and perfect will. Ayan, sabi ni Lord. So, we need to renew our mind daily. Kasi bakit? Kapag punong-puno na tayo ng mga negative thoughts, negative mindset dun sa atin, sa isipan natin, talagang pag napuno yan, dun tayo nagkakaroon na ng burden. Meron ng yoke of fear, yoke of of doubt sa buhay natin, yun na yung mas nananaig. Kaya kailangan po nating everyday, daily, Lord, renew my mindset so that I will know your pleasing and perfect will. Ayan. Madami po kasi, ayan, we need to dream big. We need to dream and pray big. Kasi madami sa atin ngayon, we have negative mindset. Madaming slavery mindset, mentality. Ayan. Dito, ito, kung mapapansin ninyo, itong setup natin ngayon na madaming isolated at home, it's like a slave, slavery. Diba? Parang nung panahon nung dati, dun sa Egypt, they're being isolated just to work for Egypt, yung mga Israelites. But then, parang sa atin ngayon, diba? We're just stuck at home. We are just stuck to do less restrictions sa buhay natin. Hindi natin magawa yung mga originally na dapat pinapagawa ni Lord sa atin that we can freely do. But then, right now, we should ask the Lord right now, na, Lord, I pray that mag-end na itong COVID-19 na ito and change this COVID-19 and heal our land. Ayan. Ito, number two. Ayan, number two, memorandum during crisis. Number one, yung sa mga hindi po nakasama kanina, ayan, number one na memorandum natin, we need to have and fix our thoughts. Ayan, nasa points po natin. Number two, we need to plan carefully and plan ahead. Now, we have this crisis. It is happening right now. Ayan, you should have a preventive measures ready. Right? Madami ngayon, di ba? Parang katulad example na lang din dun sa Baguio. Nung nangyari yung 1991 earthquake, madaming mga Pilipino, madaming mga taga Baguio, hindi ready dun sa earthquake na yon. Ay, di ba? Ang nangyari, madaming nagiba, madaming mga hindi naka-recover immediately kasi bakit? We are not ready. But then right now, God is prolonging this crisis apparently, but then I know God is teaching us to plan ahead, to plan carefully. Ano ba dapat natin gawin? It is not only in our finances, in spiritually, also in economically, so business natin, or your relationship with God, or in this sakuna, kung may ganito na mga sakit na pandemic crisis na nangyayari. Dapat we need to be ready. Tama? Amen po ba? So, example, ano kailangan natin gawin? You should tell ourselves, what should I do? Ano, before and during crisis, ano bang kailangan kong gawin? Or else, pagkatapos ng COVID-19 na ito, ng intense na quarantine na ito, ng self-isolation na ito, ano ba yung dapat kong gawin? Balik sa quarantine, old life, babalik na lamang, pasok na naman, or di kaya trabaho na naman, pero wala kang na-expect na greater, wala kang na-achieve, wala tayong nagawang nagawa as excellently. So dapat ngayon ang kailangan mag-isip tayo. Ayan, you have your goals na nabanggit ko kanina, ba? Tama. Dapat meron tayong clear, concise, and time-bound na goals. Nabanggit ko kanina, kailangan ano yung goals mo, ano yung dream mo. So, dapat pinaghahandaan mo yun. Gusto mo magkaroon ng bahay. Di dapat mag-prepare ka. Ano bang kailangan mong gawin ngayon? Gusto mo magkaroon ng strong 12, strong 144. Now that God is isolating you, kailangan mag-plan ka. Kailangan gumawa ka ng measures that you're going to build your strong 12 and strong 144. Gusto mong mag-multiply yung church mo. Yan. Dapat kailangan mag-plan tayo ahead. Diba? Tama. Ito, 1 month from now, after this COVID-19, anong kailangan natin gawin? Or 3 months from now, syempre, itong COVID-19 na ito, the economy in the whole world is having recession. Talagang nagde-decline na lahat ng mga peso, lahat ng US dollars right now. But then, anong kailangan natin gawin? Tayong mga Pilipino, tayong mga bilang mamamayan, anong kailangan mong gawin? Dapat 6 months from now, 1 year from now, 5 years from now, you want to become a successful businessman. You want to become a coach. You want to become a 144 leader, a 1728 leader. Ano kailangan natin gawin? Or 20 years from now, are you preparing for your children? Are you preparing for your business? Are you preparing for your retirement? Dapat yun ang lagi nating iniisip. Are you preparing for your investments? Dapat hindi tayo mag-focus na, wala na naman relief good na naibigay, o wala na naman hong pera. every day, every year na lang akong kapos, wala na akong naiipon. Dapat ngayon, ang kailangan natin gawin, 20 years from now, isipin mo, nagkakaedad ka na. Ayan. Hindi pa tayo nagbabago, lagi na lang tayong ano, gastos dito, gastos dyan, wala na tayong iniipon. Dapat we need to think twice. We need to think carefully and plan ahead. Because we're getting old right now. Amen po ba lahat tayo, we're getting old. We cannot shut down na mag-stuck na lang tayo dun sa age natin. Yan, other people, they're on their age na 19. You're only 16 years old. Praise God, you're only 16 years old, but you're learning all these things. But you need to plan ahead for your future. Ayan, amen po ba? Yan, nagkakapos ko, wala kang pang tuition. Ano kailangan mong gawin? Or wala nang trabaho yung parents mo? Ano kailangan mong gawin? You need to plan ahead. Amen po ba? Ayan, write down your list and your plans and your problem-solving actions. Ano kailangan natin gawin? Ayan, mag-ipon. Every day, mag-ipon ako ng barya. Ayan, maghahanap ako ng trabaho, ng home-based na trabaho. Amen po ba? Right? Ayan, we should learn from our mistakes. Kung dati, wala kang ipon. Kung dati, nangihingi ka na lang ng pera sa nanay at tatay mo, dapat ngayon, magkaroon na ng pagbabago. Amen po ba? We need to act in the present and plan for the future. Amen po? Right? Kung maaari lang, dapat talagang pinag-iipunan natin yung retirement, meron dapat sana tayong life insurance. You know, in America, here also in Australia, meron po kaming medical insurance, we have the life insurance. Because, yan, if something happens, like we got sick, we got into an accident, meron kaming life insurance, or something happened, if there's some instances na there is death, right na, in all some cases na mga ganon, we are being prepared. Kasi bakit ito? We're planning ahead, that is part of the planning process, the problem-solving process. Ayan. Amen po ba? Type amen kung nakakasabay po tayong lahat. Alright. Ayan. Sabi niya dito, just a confirmation, in Proverbs chapter 21, verse 5, good planning and hard work lead to prosperity, but hasty shortcuts lead to poverty. Ayan. Diba? Alam natin yung mga maging scout alert tayo. Ayan na ba? Alam natin yung mga Boy Scout and Girl Scouts. Sino po dito yung mga Boy Scout and Girl Scouts? Mag-wave-wave po tayo, wave-wave. Ayan. So, di ba lagi silang mga always ready? Dapat tayo maging always ready din tayo. Amen po ba? Dapat lagi tayong maging handa sa sakuna. Right? Amen po? Type amen. Ayan. So, number 3, ayan, I'll just repeat po yung title natin, the 5 memorandums during crisis. Number 1, fix your thoughts. Number 2, ayan, number 2, ano po yung number 2 natin? Plan carefully or plan ahead. And number 3, ito, change your stimulus. Ayan, ano nga bang stimulus, Ate Ivy? Ayan, ang stimulus, yan yung pampasigla. Amen po ba? I will just explain to you kung ano po yung stimulus. Stimulus or stimulant po is something that rouses or incites to activity, something that causes a reaction or action. Ayan. Stimulus, it is an agent or such an environmental change that directly influences the activity of living organism of one its parts. Ayan, ano nga ba po ang gustong, ang ibig ko pong sabihin dito sa stimulus? Baguhin po natin yung stimulus natin. Ayan, example po ng stimulus. Example po ng stimulus, ayan, eto. TikTok, ayan, Facebook, TV, ayan, news, radio, Twitter, social media, YouTube, Netflix. Ayan pa yung mga current na ano natin, stimulus natin. Tama? Or yung stimulus mo, yung bunganga ng mama mo. Na lagi ka nalang ginigising dahil na, ano, lagi ng COVID-19, lagi ka nalang late na natutulog or nagigising. Ayan, yun yung mga stimulus. Ayan. Or di kaya, yung kapitbahay mo na hindi nagpapatulog. Ayan. Lagi nalang nag-aaway dito, away dyan. Right. Ayan po yung mga stimulus natin. Ayan. Ayan, so sabi nito, surround yourself with productive energy and uplifting and powerful environment sa atin. Alam niyo po, ito sabihin ko lang, no? Huwag tayong maging kilos worm. Ayan, sabihin mo sa katabi mo, kung meron kang katabi, sabihin mo sa sarili mo, huwag kilos worm or uod. Ito pong, ano pong ibig kong sabihin, di ba, pansinin niyo po yung uod. Di ba? Yung uod, di ba, yung uod or yung worm, pag pinindot mong ganyan, pag pinitpit mo siyang ganyan, di ba, babaluktot siya. Parang ganun po tayong minsan eh. Para tayong kilos uod. Parang konting pindot mo na lang, talagang babaluktot ka na. Yan, di ba, yung mga walls natin, konting ano na lang, konting sampal na lang, talagang gigiba na. Gigiba na yung faith mo, gigiba na yung relationship mo kay Lord, gigiba na yung pananampalataya mo. Amen po ba? Huwag po tayong maging kilos uod, tama po? Dapat we need to be productive, we need to be uplifting. Amen po. Kasi bakit madami tayo ngayon, yan uod. Kilos uod na lang tayo na narinig natin na oh COVID-19 lagong lumalala. COVID-19 parang laging nagiging worse, mas madaming namamatay, madami nang hindi nabibigyan ng relief goods. Grabe, nakakaawa. Para ngayon, oo nga, magmukmuk na lang ako dito sa bahay. Madami po, alam niyo po, ang nakakaawa. I've heard a lot of news na nakarinig sila ng nagiging worse na ang COVID-19. Madami pong nagpakamatay, unfortunately, in a different countries. Dito rin po sa Australia, madami na rin pong nagpakamatay because they're being so depressed. Yun, nakatutok na lang po sila dun sa TV. Nakatutok na lang sila dun sa ratings, dun, nakatutok na lang sila dun sa pagbabantay ng cases all over the globe dito sa Australia. So which is very sad thing that is happening right now. Kaya dapat po sa atin ngayon, we need to change our stimulus. Kailangan natin i-divert natin ang our attention. Divert our gaze, our focus. Ayan. Kasi dapat ang maging focus po natin ngayon, dapat, ito, in verse, ito, just a Bible verse na basahin ko po, no? In Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 18 to 21, it says here, so commit yourselves wholeheartedly to these words of mine. Tie them to your hands and wear them on your forehead as reminders. Teach them to your children. Talk about them when you're at home, when you're on the road, when you're going to bed and when you're going to get up. Write them onto your doorposts of your house and your gates, and so that as long as the skies above the earth, you and your children may flourish in the land the Lord swore to your ancestors. It says there, sabi niya, ito po, di ba sabi ko po kanina, change your stimulus, wag maging kilos uod. Ayan, we need to change our environment, sabi ni Lord dito, di ba? Yung mga words niya, yung mga Bible verses yun natin, di ba? Lagi nating ipaskil daw natin sa mga bahay natin, pag-usapan natin, pag-gising natin, kapag nasa daan ka, kapag bago ka matulog, kung nasa sasakyan ka, magpatugtog ka ng mga worship songs. Ayan, yung mga example natin. Play worship songs. Instead of watching TV, shut the TV. Ayan, manood ka lang ng TV parang 1 minute or 2 minutes, then turn it off. Ayan, kasi it's not giving a positive feedback in our life, positive impact in our life. Instead, it's getting deteriorating, it's getting worse. Ayan, amen po ba? Kaya yan, play music, play worship songs, play podcast. Manood po tayo ng mga podcast ayan, ng TVCH, pastor natin. And watch our live streams as well. O yung mga preachings ni Bishop Ariel. Ayan, sinishare din natin, pinapanood natin. Or even study the Word of God. Ayan, yung audio-visual natin. And need to study all the digital books as well. Or yung inspirational books. I to encourage. Doon po tayo mag-focus. Or manood tayo ng, instead of manood ka ng Netflix, yung mga, okay lang naman po, manood ng Netflix, yung mga, excuse me, mga nakakatawa. But then, I think it's more beneficial to watch movies and documentaries that are Bible-based. Amen po ba? From New Testament to Old Testament. Yan, panoorin po natin. Amen po ba? Say amen. Type amen po. Ayan. Or watch people who are successful in the business, ayan, or in the church ministry, yun po yung panoorin natin, or even write down all the Bible verses. I do encourage you po, when you're at home, ngayon, isulat po natin, or iprint mo dun sa, no, sa printer ninyo, ipaskill mo dyan sa kwarto, ayan, sa cellphone mo, i-type mo yung mga Bible verses, or in your room, in the kitchen, while you're cooking, ngayon, ilagay po natin yung mga Bible verses, because it's reminding us daily that we need to meditate all these words ng Panginoon, or even affirmations na, like, I do encourage you po, I'm always watching in and I'm always playing affirmations in whenever I woke up before I go to bed, when I'm sleeping, I play worship songs and affirmations, yung reprogramming, kasi bakit ito, 'di ba, saturated na yung mind natin when we're working, when we're overloaded, when being pressured right now in our work. Yan, sometimes in your school, ayan, sa akin sa work, sa school, when I'm overpressured, parang talagang overloaded na ako, ng parang yung mga stimulus na mga yon, ang ginagawa ko, I'm playing reprogramming videos dun sa YouTube. Search nyo pa yun dun sa YouTube, madaming mga na, reprogramming na mga videos po doon. Talang it really helps po. Ayan, it's boosting my confidence, it's boosting my relationship with God, and mga Bible verses na mga videos na talagang 1 hour, 3 hours that it's been playing when I'm sleeping. Doon po talagang na, I can feel that it's stirring up my spirit, stirring up the fire inside of me, yung presence ng Holy Spirit, presence ng Panginoon. So I do encourage you po, ayan, yung affirmations that I'm strong, I'm bold, I'm courageous, I'm excellent, I'm successful, I'm victorious. Yun po yung lagi po nating na i-declare, lagi po nating namnamin sa buhay natin daily. Ayan. Or into your laptops, in your houses. Ayan, gawin po natin yung maging daily na routine po natin. Isulat nyo po dun sa cellphone ninyo, I'm a child of God, I'm created in the image and likeness of God. Lagi ko pa yung mga dinedeclare. I'm bold, I'm successful, I'm triumphant. Ayan, I'm a multi-billionaire, I'm a businesswoman. Yun po yung lagi kong ginagawa. And I know it's reflecting in my character, in my attitude, yung mga dinedeclare ko na yun, yung mga positive things na yun. I'm also casting out every spirits na that doesn't rely on na yung mga nagagaling sa mga demonyo, the lie of the enemy. I'm been casting all of those, like the lie of the enemy, the deception, the condemnation of the enemy. Dapat hindi na dapat yun ang mini-benedict po natin. Amen po ba? Right? Amen po ba? Ayan. So, number 4 po. So, just ulitin ko lang, yung number 1 na memorandum natin is to fix your thoughts. Number 2, plan ahead or plan carefully. Number 3 po is change your stimulus. And number 4 is live wisely by practicing God's command and principles. Ulitin ko po, live wisely by practicing God's commands and principles. It says here in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 15 to 16. Ayan, it says here, so be careful how you live. Don't live like fools, but like those who are wise. Make the most of every opportunity in these evil days. Don't act thoughtlessly, but understand what the Lord wants you to do. Ayan, ask the Lord, Lord, what do you want me to do? Anong gusto mong gawin ko dito sa, while having this isolation, this COVID-19? Ano nga bang gawin ko, kailangan kong gawin dito na nasa bahay ako? Kailangan kong tulungan yung nanay ko, yung tatay ko. Ayan, sa mga gawaing bahay, magluto, maglinis. Ayan, linisin yung bahay, linisin yung kwarto mo. Ayan. Ilang araw na yung, ilang weeks na yung COVID-19, pero hanggang ngayon, hindi mo pa nalilinisan yung kwarto mo. Amen po ba? Type amen kung kailangan mo nang linisan yung kwarto mo or yung bahay nyo. Mag-declutter ka na. Amen po ba? Right? Amen. Ayan. It says here also, do everything in outstanding success. Amen. Yan, kailangan gawin mo ngayon. Ngayon, dapat itong COVID-19 na ito, I need to be outstanding and be successful in everything that I need to do, even despite I'm at home. Dapat yun ang kailangan, or di kaya, ang gawin mo, yan, do immediate actions dun sa mga problems na na-determine mo. Diba? Madami ngayon na mga, dati, I've watched some of the news dati na, mostly, itong mga, syempre, itong mga foreigners, they're usually out, na hindi nila kasama yung mga anak nila, lagi na lang sa daycare, nasa nasa childcare, so iba yung mga nag-aalaga sa kanila when they're at home already ngayon, that they're having difficulty to bond with their kids. They're having difficulty to take care of their kids. Ayan, wala yung bonding, wala yung caring to each other, helping to one another, wala na yung closure kasi bakit lagi silang out. Pero ngayon, di ba, just like I've said a while ago, God is rebuilding houses. God is restoring houses. Yan. So ngayon, ang kailangan natin ngayon, make the most out of it. Bumawi ka. O yun, i-massage mo yung nanay mo. I-massage mo yung tatay mo. Diba? Amen po ba? Ayan. Tawag niya ito. Pagsilbihan mo sila. Ikaw yung magluto. Ikaw yung maglinis. Alright? Amen po? Ayan. Do gardening. Ayan. Ayan. Make the most of yourself in everything you do. Be excellent. Or if you're still working, do that. Excel in your job. If you're still ongoing your business, excel in your business. Amen po ba? Right? Act the best you can. Ayan. Right? Amen. So, it says here also in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, this is very common to every one of us. It says here, study this book of instruction continually. Meditate on it day and night so that you'll be careful to obey everything written in it. Then only you will prosper and succeed in all you do. Amen. So, just like I've said a while ago, we need to study and meditate the Word of God so that we will be careful to do everything written in. Ngayon, it is COVID-19, ang minimeditate mo, TikTok. Ang minimeditate mo, yung Netflix. Paano ka mag-excel? Paano ka magiging successful if you're meditating on those? Right? Amen? Ate, ano, pampa-stress relief lang. Pero, tignan mo, hindi mo napapansin. From 8 a.m. gumising ka hanggang 10 p.m. TikTok pa rin ang pinapanood mo. Diba? TikTok pa rin ang ginagawa mo. How are you going to excel? Right? How are you going to improve? Ayan. Amen po. So, tingnan mo, ang nangyayari yan, mukhang TikTok na yung ano, itsura natin dahil sa ano, yun kaka-meditate natin sa TikTok. Alright? Ayan, so, and Netflix, and so, ayan, it says here also in Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 6, it says here, plant your seed in the morning and keep busy all afternoon. It says there, for you don't know if profit will come from one activity or another, or maybe both. Right, it says there, plant in the morning. It says there in the other translation as well. Sow your seed in the morning and at the evening, let your hands not be idle, for you don't know which will succeed, whether this or not, whether both will do equally. Sabi niya. Ito, sabi niya dito, sow your seed in the morning. Kailangan sabi niya dito, keep yourself busy all the afternoon. Right? Amen po? Kailangan maging busy tayo. Pero huwag mong sabihin, ate, busy ako kakapanood ng TikTok eh. Busy ako kakapanood ng Netflix, ate. Diba? Hindi na natin nagagawa yung kung anong kailangan natin gawin. Pinapagluto ka ng nanay mo, ng tatay mo, but then you're being busy to do all these works, this job. Right? Amen po? So we need to be productive in a way that it's getting benefits in our life and into our family as well. Right, there's no point of living if you are a worthless human. Ito, masakit po ito eh. Ito yung ni-reveal sa akin ni Lord. There is no point of living if you are a worthless human. Yan. Walang kwenta na nabubuhay po tayo, pero kung walang kwenta yung ginagawa natin daily. Wala pong kwenta yung, yan. If we're doing activities that is worthless, that is not giving benefits in our lives. Diba? Naalala nyo po yun. Binigyan tayo ng free will ni Lord to do everything that we want to do. But then, not everything is beneficial po. Right? Amen po ba? So, it says here also, make sure in this quarantine, you should accomplish something essential and significant that is leading to your dreams, your goals, your aspirations, or your commitment and plans with God. Says there. Dapat siguraduhin mo dito sa quarantine na ito. Ayan, you should accomplish things that is very important and essential. Talagang makaka-apekto dun sa magiging future mo or kung gusto mong maging doktor. Ayan, kung gusto mong magkaroon ng anak or gusto mong maging father or mother o gusto mong engage into a marriage life. Ayan, dapat kailangan nating paghandaan yung mga yan. or gusto mong mag-expand sa business mo, kailangan mong paghandahan. Gusto mong magkaroon ng earnings na check na millions, dapat paghandahan mo. Nanonood nga kay mom. Right. Ayan. Example, ito yung mga kailangan natin gawin. Example yan, clean your room, clean your car, declutter your house. Ayan, ito sa akin talaga po, before I'm teaching this, because I did it myself before ko, ayan, nilinis ko yung buong kwarto, yung sakyan ko po, ay nag-declutter kami in this house, we're sanitizing, we're also practicing yung good sanitation as well dito sa bahay. So now, ito, sabi ko nga kanina, number four point is, you need to live wisely by practicing God's commands and principles. So, ano kailangan mong gawin? Mabuhay ka in living in the God principle in a godly-based life. Amen po, right? Ayan, dapat wala ng compromise. Wala na yung ano, hindi yung tipong gagamitin mo, will take advantage of this opportunity na, oh, COVID-19, nandito lang ako sa bahay, makikipag-chat, makikipag-text ako sa ano, sa mga lalaki, ganun sa mga babae, mag-chicks ako. Hindi, dapat hindi yun yung focus natin. Amen po ba? Hindi ito yung time na maging magbulahan. Hindi po ito yung time na maging stagnant tayo, maging reluctant. No! Or to be slumber or lazy. No! Dapat we need to close that door of slavery or the laziness in our lives. Dapat find time right now. Ito ang kailangan natin gawin. Find home-based jobs. Madaming po mga home-based jobs dyan. Ate, paano naman kung ano, hindi ko alam yung trabaho na yan. Dapat kailangan pag-aralan mo. Right? Amen po ba? Consult to the expert. Amen po ba? Yan. So, do gardening or planting at home. Mag-plant ka. Diba? Sinasabi mo, wala nang pagkain sa bahay. Di magtanim ka. Magtanim ka ng kamatis dyan. O, diba? Alright? Ng itlog o yung mga ganyan. Paitlogin yung mga manok natin. Bili ka ng itlog. Hintayin mo silang umitlog. Right? Amen po ba? Di magkaka-result yun ng ano, ng ulam. Tama po? Amen? Right. Ayan. So, and now, radically win your family and friends right now. Take advantage to share to them the gospel and pray with them. Amen po ba? Glory to God po. Starting this COVID-19, this past few weeks na almost na live stream na lang. And praise God, glory to God po na I've been watching live stream with my siblings and we're praying also last time we had our communion, which is, it is unusual, it is uncommon with us kasi sometimes we have our different timetables in our job, in our work, and hindi na kami laging nagkakasama. So, yun, God is doing, yun, like I've said a while ago, God is restoring house and homes and rebuilding every families and every communities right now. And I do believe, I know, I pray and I urge you, brothers and sisters, I urge you, church, to do and share the gospel to your family, those who haven't accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior yet. Or consolidate or get in touch with your disciples and your family who backslided towards Jesus. Praise God po, glory to God. Just like a short testimony, I've heard news from all my disciples, dati na hindi ko nag-get in touch with for a long time, for years. And now, God has opened their hearts na they've contacted me and accepted again to do discipleship and one-to-one. So, praise God, glory to God. I know God is doing revival type. Amen po ba? Amen. Right? Ayan. So, also do online trainings and cell groups. Engage in, or right now, you're already preparing for your marriage life. Yan, mag-engage ka in pre-marriage counselings or programs. Or do right now, study how to be successful in parenthood or raising a child. Others, now you're already, others are there, they're pregnant and now you're about to have your child. So now, dapat, what should you do? You should prepare before you're mag-give birth yung asawa mo. Dapat now, you should prepare how to be a successful parent, to become effective and efficient parent to your children. Amen po ba? To supply their needs. Amen po ba? Right? Amen. Ayan, or continually planting seeds or giving your tithes and offerings as well. This is really important that even despite of the COVID-19, we use our resources. We keep our resources. But even despite of our scarcity, of our luckness, we should still be faithful in giving our tithes and offering. Dapat hindi natin po pag nakawan si Lord, katulad ni Ananias and Sapphira na they've told to Peter that they've given everything. But then, hindi po nila na ibigay. We should keep our commitment to the Lord. Kasi bakit? We are robbing the Lord if we are not giving our commitment to the Lord financially. Amen po ba? Right? And, or this one, what should you do aside from that? Coordinate with the people to send financial help or give relief goods. Ayan, if you have the capacity, financial capacity, if you have like extra money, if you have savings, I do encourage every one of you guys, every one of you church to give at least small amount or even big amounts, whatever God is knocking on you, to give financial help to those who are poor, to those who are in need right now, to your family, to those church members that was desperately asking for help. Amen po ba? Right? Oh, yan, eto, what should you need to do as well? You need to study how to save and earn money. Amen po? You need to earn and save money for your house, for your car, or for your business to earn to build up a new business. Ayan, amen po ba? Right? You need to study all of those so that you'll be successful. Maximize your time. Yeah, maximize your time to accept to share the word of God to your Facebook friends. I always do this to my Facebook friends. I let them, these random people, even complete stranger, I share to them the gospel and they accept Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. A lot of testimonies po, glory to God. Those who are in the Philippines, I've been sharing to them the gospel in to the different countries. Ayan, praise God, glory to God. They have responded and they've told me, praise God, you know, when I prayed that prayer, I felt like something like strange happened in my life. A big change and transformation happened in my life when you prayed that prayer. So they've been so thankful and glory to God for using me to become a mouthpiece and a weapon to destroy the plan of the enemy and to steer up the plan of God in their lives. And be productive, guys, and be excellent. So, and this number five memorandum during crisis is to respond and submit to authorities. It says here, respond and submit to authorities. I'll just repeat the five memorandums during crisis. Number one, fix your thoughts. Number two, plan ahead or plan carefully. And number three, change your stimulus. And number four, live a life with live wisely by practicing God's commands and principles. And number four, respond and submit to the authorities. Who are the authorities right now in this pandemic crisis? These are the government officials. These are the prime ministers, the nurses, the doctors, especially God. It says here in Romans chapter 13 verse 1-2, it says here, everyone must submit to governing authorities, for all authorities come from God, and those in positions of authorities have placed by God, says here. So God, we need to submit to the governing authorities. It says here also in verse 2. So anyone who rebels against authority is rebelling against what God is instituted, and they will be punished. Right? Yan, madami po sa atin ngayon, madaming pasaway. Madami po, unfortunately, to hear that a lot of people is rallying in the Philippines, which is like shameful and ridiculous to hear, na instead of praying and supporting them, they're still opposing the mandatory restrictions and mandatory laws being imposed by our President Duterte. So guys, we need to submit to the mandatory laws and restrictions that being engaged by us by or asked by our government officials. It says here, diba ang kailangan natin gawin ngayon? If this government official says magkaroon tayo ng quarantine, to keep our quarantine, we need to keep the quarantine. Right now, unfortunately, kanina, I've been watching the telly. And madami pong mga kinasuhan. And talagang nakita sa CCTV yan na naka-lockdown dun sa hotels nila. It is a foreigner, it is a visitor, and nakita sa TV na lumabas siya dun sa hotel, gusto niya daw palang i-meet yung girlfriend niya, which is very breaching the mandatory laws and restrictions. So it is desperately na talagang depressing right now na nangyayari sa atin. So right now, the mandatory laws na kailangan natin gawin, of course, number one, ito, we need to wash our hands. Ayan, practice the precautionary measures, or practice yung coughing etiquette. Yung dito po kasi pinapractice namin here in Australia, we do the coughing etiquette like this. Instead of coughing in our mouth, diba? Kasi the transmission of COVID-19 is through our mouth and through our nose. So if you've just coughed and tapos ginamit mo yung kamay mo and put it into your mouth, yan, that's the time that it's spreading the virus and proliferating yung virus dun sa ating katawan. Kaya madami, widespread na lang, ang bilis na lang ng transmission ng COVID-19 ito. Kasi bakit? Madaming mga taong pasaway. Ayan, madami pang naririnig ko dati when they're coughing, especially in China. This is very sad thing that is happening because they want to other people to become infected as well. They're like just coughing and then just touching a person and then intentionally and like just rubbing it to the doorpost, into the doorknobs, which is very sad, into the side rails, in the trains, in the buses, which is ridiculous na gusto nila kasi lahat mga tao ma-infect. So yun, kailangan nating, we need to practice and wash our hands, practice the coughing etiquette. So yun, instead of opposing and blaming all the problems to the government authorities, we should respect them, we should pray for them. Yan. Nakakaiyak lang nung nakita ko nung si President Duterte, that he's been crying and he's not sleeping at all. Tayo, ang sarap ng tulog natin, pero si President Duterte, he never sleep. Kasi bakit? He's like just worried. Paano kaya yung mga Pilipino, yung mga four-piece mga Filipino, hindi sila makakain for tomorrow. But then, other people, they don't realize na our president is suffering because of he's suffering, and also a lot of people is suffering right now. But then we should just respect and pray for them. Amen po ba? Ayan. So it says here, let us turn every opposition into submission. Submit to God, especially number one, submit to God. Submit to our authorities right now. And I have my conclusion right now. It says here in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9, it says here, that is what the scriptures mean when they say, no eye has heard, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has imagined what God has prepared for those who love Him. I know, as I said a while ago, the 5 R's in this COVID-19 crisis, that God is rebuilding, God is replenishing, God is restoring, God is reviving. Yan. God is doing these things that we can never measure. God is like doing something, immeasurable things na hindi natin ma-imagine na, Lord, ano nga bang mangyayari after ng COVID-19 na ito? Are we still going to recover? Yes, we can recover. Yes. But you need to start hoping first, right? So that other people will hope as well. We need to make a campaign right now. That we should make a campaign that don't lose hope. Ayan, hashtag unite in prayer. Ito, I do encourage everyone na let's make it viral na unite, don't lose hope, and hashtag unite in prayer, kung pwede natin gawin yun to encouraged everyone, a lot of people in different continents in the whole earth, that so that everyone will go into impose their faith on Jesus Christ, not onto the vaccine, not onto the scientific intervention right now. No, the prayer changes everything. Amen po ba? Prayer is something that is going to change and make a breakthrough in our lives. Amen po ba? Si Lord lang ang makakapag-heal sa ating lahat. Amen po? God can recover everything. Ayan, hashtag unite in prayer. If we can do this and share it to our post, Facebook post, the hashtag unite in prayer. Don't lose hope. Ayan, madami ng mga tao ngayon. Lalo na, alam niyo po, yung mga matatanda. Kung sa totoo lang, in the whole world, yan yung mga vulnerable people right now. They are the ones who's very worried. Kasi bakit? Sila yung mga madaling mamatay. Those who have low immune system, very weak immune system. But then right now, pray to God that God will strengthen your immune system. Ayan, God is accomplishing His unfinished business here on earth. Amen po ba? Si Lord, ina-accomplish na niya yung unfinished business niya na here on earth. Si Lord, diba, mapapansin niyo, God is pruning us. God is pruning us. God is disciplining us. Sabi ko nga kanina, God is refining us. Ayan, right now, si Lord, kinakaltasan na niya tayo. Ayan. Although, sadly, I can feel the second coming is very near and very close. But then, you know that the second coming is very near. But then, what should you need to do right now? Ano yung kailangan mong gawin? Yung minention ko kanina, the five memorandums. Kailangan mong, you need to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Build your strong relationship to Jesus Christ. Do the Great Commission. Win souls and make disciples. It says there in Matthew 28 verse 19 to 20. Go therefore and make disciples, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Teaching them. Teach all these people to build their relationship to Jesus instead of worrying that they will be infected by the COVID-19. No! We should stop that mentality to people. Amen po ba? Right? And God is breaking spirit of stagnation, limitation, and restrictions in this generation. We are being stagnant already. For the past few weeks, past few months, madaming mga stuck na lang at home, hindi na nagtatrabaho, wala na source of income. That is stagnant. That is nakahiga na lang sa kwarto, nanonood na lang, wala nang ginagawa, wala nang na-accomplish. But then right now, don't let yourself be stagnant. Ayan. You must break the stagnation in your life. The limitation, the restrictions. Amen po ba? Right? We are moving from glory to glory. From favor to favor. From blessings to massive blessings. From breakthrough to breakthrough. From revival to revival. And miracle upon miracle. Right? Amen po ba? God is doing these things in our lives. But then, the question is, are you believing on it? Are you joining this massive campaign of God that God is doing this revival in our lives? What are you doing? Stop lying down. Stop sitting down on your chair. You should do and act something. Do something else. Help someone to be saved. Do the salvation that their people will be saved as well. You should do the things that pleasing to the Lord. Amen po ba? Right now, you should accept the fact that people need to accept Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. You need to lengthen the page of the people who accept Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior in the book of life. Amen po. Kailangan po natin talagang ang goal natin ngayon, dapat kailangan natin pahabain yung pages ng Book of Life na dapat andun na yung pangalan ng pamilya mo, ng nanay mo, ng tatay mo, ng mga kapatid mo, ng relatives mo, ng yung employer mo, yung client mo. Amen po ba? Do not let these people crying in hell because they're not saved. Because they didn't accept Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. Amen po ba? Type amen. Right? Amen po. So yan, so just ulitin ko lang the five memorandums during this crisis. I'm almost finished po. Just ulitin ko lang po yung ano natin, yung topic natin. So yung the five memorandum during this crisis. Number one, fix your thoughts. And number two, plan carefully and ahead. Number three, change your stimulus. Number four, live wisely by practicing God's commands and principles. And number five, respond and submit to authorities. Amen po ba? Amen? Type amen po sa inyong lahat. Yan, whoever is watching right now. Right? God is doing these 5 hours in our life in this pandemic crisis. 5 hours. God is number one, restoring. Number two, refining. Number three, reuniting. Number four, God is rebuilding. And number five, God is doing this revival. If you are watching right now and you haven't accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I do encourage you. You know, I just want to quick share to these people who's randomly watching this right now. If you're watching this and you haven't accept Jesus Christ and you haven't been saved, you didn't accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, I do encourage you right now. God has a plan for you. Plan to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. God has a plan to you to heal you, to change you, to shift your no faith to building a relationship with Jesus. But then I just want to reiterate that we are sinning. We need to acknowledge that we have a sin. That is the reason why being away, being apart from the Lord. But then I just want to reinforce to you that Jesus loves you so much. He loves you so much. He's not looking into your past. He's not looking into your mistakes right now. But the problem is, are you ready to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? God has a plan for you to be prosperous and successful. But right now, did you really accept Jesus in your as your personal Lord and Savior? If you haven't done yet, I do encourage you. It says there in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 to 9. Salvation is based on what Jesus did on the cross. It is not from ourselves. It is a gift from God so that no one can boast. It says there, we are being saved through what Jesus did on the cross. And we need to have our faith in Him and to build a strong relationship with Him right now. But the point is, are you ready? Is Jesus present in your life right now? So I do encourage you right now, if you're watching this, if you just heard this, it just dropped by into this live stream, you have been watching from different countries, different nationalities. God is not looking into your nationality, on your culture, on your background. No. No, He's not looking on that position of your life, of your educational attainment, of your money. No, God is not looking into that. God is looking into your heart if you're willing to accept Him as your personal Lord and Savior. I just want to share this, you know, others who have been watching this already, they have accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. But for the courtesy of those people who haven't accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, I just want to pray this simple prayer with me. I do encourage you. This prayer has changed my life. My life has been changed. Your life will never be the same again if you pray this prayer. This prayer is free. This prayer has changed and shifted my life and changed me of who I am today right now. I do encourage you, if you're with me right now, open your mouth. If you're just at home and to your car, wherever you are, you're at your work right now, if you're praying, if your friend just shared this live stream to you, please coordinate and pray this prayer right now. Come on. Type amen if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ. If you are ready to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, please. I want to know if you are a first timer, if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, and you are ready, please type amen in there right now in this live stream. I will just pray right now for you. Please pray with me every word that I am praying, and sincerely pray this prayer and your life will never be the same again after in this prayer. Oh, come on, let us pray. Lord, come on, say these words right now. Open your mouth. Come on, say this prayer. Lord, thank you for this, the life that you've given to me. Forgive me for all of my sins. And come on, pray with me right now. Pray this prayer. Forgive me for all of my sins. Forgive me for all of my sins, intentionally and unintentionally, in words, in actions, in my mind. Please, I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. Help me to build a strong relationship with you, to build my strong faith and my love on you, so that I can serve you for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. Thank you. Thank you for praying that prayer. And for other people that has been watching right now, those who are disciples, leaders, cell members, pastors, thank you so much for tuning in. And I do encourage everyone to share this live stream to your friends and family. Thank you so much in behalf of my pastor, Pastor Lotharia, Pastor Jeanette. Thank you for giving me this opportunity and this privilege to preach out the good news, the word for tonight. And thank you for lending me your ears. Thank you for spending your time, even despite of the time difference, even despite na gabi dyan, if it's the night time here, the time it's already 10 o'clock, I mean. But then I know our efforts, our time, our time is not a wasted. It is time invested. Amen po ba? Thank you so much. Glory to God. I pray that everyone who's been affected by this COVID-19, please, if you need help, contact your leaders. Ask for prayers. Ask for a word from them. Ask for advices from them. Huwag kang magmukmok. Huwag kang meditate ng negative. Start on communicating with God, praying with God, because God can change everything. Amen po ba? Thank you so much. Glory to God. Thank you po. Maraming salamat. Thank you in my church members, my family, True Vine City Harvest Church in the Philippines, in Macau, in Hong Kong, my family who has been watching in UK. Thank you so much for watching and tuning in. I love you all. I love you, church. I miss you all. And I'm Ivy Claire once again. Stay safe. God bless you all. And before I cut this prayer, I'll cut this live stream, let us pray right now. Lord, thank you so much for this opportunity that you've given to me. I pray I apply the blood of Jesus, Lord God. May your fire, Lord God, will engulf everyone who's been watching this, Lord God, that they will be protected by your fire, by your anointing, Lord God, that they will be empowered, Lord God, that they will be uplifted, Lord God, shift their goals, Lord God, shift their eyes, their minds, fix their thoughts, Lord God, help them to change their stimulus, Lord God, they will live wisely, Lord God, according to your principles, that they will respond, Lord God, and they will submit to the authorities, Lord God. Lord God, manifest your presence, Lord God, in them. Manifest miracles and signs and wonders, Lord God. Help them to recover, Lord God, those who've been infected by COVID-19, Lord God. Help them to be recovered, Lord God, that they will be healed instantly, Lord God. Now, in Jesus' name, there will be a spontaneous transformation in their lives, Lord God. Breakthrough upon breakthrough will happen in their life. Thank you, Lord God. I glorify you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Thank you so much po. God bless you all. Bye. Thank you so much. God bless you all. Love you all, church.